don't think you know how to, love.
Terry.
I know. Just give me the gun before you shoot yourself in the foot.
Terry. Terry, what's happening?
I hate you! You never left me! You left me! You wouldn't let me! You said I was coming and I didn't! You said I could come with you! And I didn't! I came here!
What's going on? Who the devil are you?
She's nobody! I hate it! Take her away!
I take it we've got a problem.
A rather big one, I'm afraid.
How big?
The worst it could be. She's in the advanced stages of the most lethal form of cancer.
But she's... I can't believe that.
Oh, what is this? This isn't April Fool's.
Rita, the tests are conclusive.
You must have been aware of some of the symptoms. A loss of energy, sweating at night.
Oh, sure, so I'm feeling a bit off, but that doesn't mean I'm down for the count.
You have non-Hodgkin's lymphoma.
Oh, well, that's not telling me anything, is it?
It's a cancer of the lymphatic system. That's the system that develops your immunity to diseases. Simply put, it means you're an easy prey to any disease or infection.
What's so like I get a cold and it finishes me off? Like my body can't defend itself?
We'll start the treatment straight away, but I'm afraid your chances of going into remission are pretty slim.
Perhaps Rita would like a few moments to herself. I'm sure she'll have some questions for you as soon as she's had a chance to think this through.
Of course.
Take as much time as you need. I understand that, but hitting her with it all at once.
Believe me, Mrs. Reynolds, it's the only way. We have to get through to her, let her know what she's up against. She has to counter that initial shock herself. There's nothing we can do for her until she comes out of it.
How long do you think that'll be? There must be counsellors who can help her work through this.
I'll have somebody assigned, but you'll have to watch her closely. There's usually a pattern that patients follow until they can accept it. Even the most introverted can become violently aggressive.
She killed him!
Shut up!
He didn't have a gun on him!
Oh, calm down!
She killed him!
Come on, get out of here. Shut up!
How long have I got?
4, maybe 5 months. With chemotherapy, it could be prolonged for a few more.
There must be some hope, Doctor. From what you read, they seem to be making breakthroughs every day.
In some cases, yes. Hodgkin's disease has been a bit of a success story, but we're talking about something different here.
We've got to do something. What's the next step?
Draw up a drug regime and start the chemotherapy treatment straight away.
Drugs, there's a twist. I knocked myself out trying to squash dope in this place and they're going to carry me out full of it.
I don't think Dr.
In some instances, we use a heroin derivative to make the patient more comfortable in the later stages.
Oh, no way. Not like Bongo. They might carry me out screaming, but they're going to carry me out straight.
Well, that's up to you. There'll be side effects of the treatment. Nausea for a few days after each session. Weight loss. You'll probably lose most of your hair. It won't be pleasant. But the staff will do everything they can for
me. No, thanks. I had enough of being poked and prodded last time I was there.
Well, there's no reason why the infirmary here couldn't be set up for your needs.
Rita, I think under the circumstances it might be possible for you to leave Wentworth.
A pardon on compassionate grounds. Mm.
Yes, it might be for the best, the aftercare and the transport facilities.
Mm. Now, just a minute! This is my carcass you're talking about. I think I should be the one figuring out what to do with it.
Of course, I'm sorry. We were just trying to do what we can.
Well, being outside would be much easier on you.
A bloody impossible for anyone else. Bongo and Slasher are gone. You think Ida hasn't got enough to worry about without playing nursemaid to me?
I'll see what I can arrange.
Look, I've had enough talk for one day, all right? You want to do something, you make sure the women don't get a whiff of this. I don't want them making a three-act play out of it.
I'll take you back to your dorm.
Oh, there's still some things I can do by myself.
Oi, Dreamboat. I'd rather be in Bali too, but we got a quota to fill.
Might have to settle for Devil's Island, the way things are going. Give us a hand with this.
Sure. Suckers like us should stick together.
What do you mean?
We both got set up by slimy little creeps,
yeah,
didn't we?
Well, at least you can get at the bastard to pull you in here.
Here, I'll do it. Anyone would think this place was full of angels the way you two carry on.
Yeah, well, it's going to be hell on earth for a certain screw I can think of.
Hey, guess what? Oh, where is Rita?
With Reno.
She's been ages.
Yeah, well, we've been covering you for ages. The work bell went 20 minutes ago. Where have you been?
They got Maxwell.
Well, how do you know?
Well, Harry's out in the garden. He heard on his radio.
That's not the best bit. She's done a murder.
Maxwell?
Oh, well, what do you expect from a bitch like that?
What are they doing with her?
Well, there's nowhere else to put her, is there?
You beauty, D-Day.
There's nothing I'd like better than a cosy little chat with Maxwell.
Yeah, well, I wouldn't get your hopes up. She's not going to be in the mood to do you or Jackson any favours.
Don't worry, Spike. We'll work something out when Reek gets back. Mm. Hey, you can be on it too, Brum. You are a couple of lumps, don't you?
Yeah, sure. I think I'll put another load in.
Great news, eh? We're laughing.
Yeah. Best news I've had all week.
Decided to take the day off, have we, Connors?
I don't know about you, but yeah. I thought I might take it easy today.
Oh, I see. It's your birthday, eh? You should have told me. We could have had a party.
Didn't you get your invitation?
You're on report, Connors. Get back to work.
Why don't you get back to work? There must be someone who still wets himself every time you shoot your mouth off.
Get up or you'll be in the
hound! Get off me or so help me, you'll swallow this.
You are way out of line, Connors.
Yes, and while I'm out there, you might learn some manners. Like, for a start, you don't treat me like a piece of crap under my feet, and you don't come barging in here like you own the place. Come on, Ferguson, I'm waiting for you. Show me just how tough you are.
Well, under the circumstances, I think she was as cool as a cucumber.
Yes, but don't forget Dr. Lund's reservations about that. Maxwell's return could be just the thing to trigger it off.
Well, I'll make sure all the other officers know what to expect.
Yes? Just a minute, Miss Ferguson. Tell him to wait there for a moment, would you? Marty, he's demanding to see me.
Well, allow me. If he wants trouble, I'll give it to him.
Something wrong, Miss Ferguson?
Connors has gone berserk. I need assistance to get her to the pound.
That won't be necessary.
It was a clear case of assault.
Did she strike you?
She pushed me out of her cell. If I had been foolish enough to go back in there, God knows what...
I'm glad you didn't provoke her any further.
I want her on the first bus out of here to a maximum security facility.
Sorry, I
you can save your apologies for the minister. I'm going to enjoy watching you pussyfoot your way out of this
one. Will you just listen to me for a minute? Rita is very ill.
Oh, what's she trying to put over you this time? If I had 10 cents
for every... She has cancer. The doctor thinks she has 4 or 5 months at the most.
It's terminal.
There is treatment, but the success rate is negligible. She's asked to stay here, so I think a little tolerance...
Allowing her to stay here is the worst thing you could do.
I'm not going to argue.
I'm not just talking about paperwork to dispose of a body. Connors has got influence. Those women will turn her into a martyr.
The women might also join together to support her, and I hope you'll do the same.
I'm not allowing myself to become a target for some crim who's got nothing to lose.
You know what I expect, and you'll see to it that my wishes are carried out. That's all, Miss Ferguson.
I would suggest that it would be in our best interests if this were kept from the other women.
That's a very good idea. Thank you for the suggestion. Now, if you don't have any other questions on how to handle your job, I suggest you get on with it.
I don't care about that. Maxwell isn't here and you shouldn't be either.
Well, I can't think of a better place to be right now and I've got all the time in the world.
Marty, you are not just under suspension. You're out on bail. Any more trouble here and they'll lock you up again.
Well, they're gonna lock me up anyway if someone doesn't get the truth out of her. So what's the difference?
Probably about 5 years if the prosecution find out.
Mum, I want to see the governor and I don't need your permission for that.
Well, she won't see you. There is nothing more you can do here. Now, you know how this place operates. If Maxwell was behind it, the women will find out soon enough.
Yeah, well, maybe they will. But everything I've got is on the line, and I am tired of people telling me what to do.
I'll talk to you again after I finish my shift.
Don't you mother me.
Right. As an officer of the Crown, I'm afraid I have to report that you are trespassing on government property.
Oh, there you go.
And believe me, if you don't get out of here right now, I'll do it.
No way. You know what she's like. Give her 5 minutes and she'll have enough backup to take us apart.
No one will go near her. She's finished.
Yeah, well, she will be when we're through with her.
Look, I've got more reason to get that bitch than anyone, but we're not laying a hand on her till she tells Reno she set me and Marty up.
Yeah, we've got no hurry. She's going to be in here longer than Alice.
Oh, get stuck.
I just don't want her to think she's getting away with it.
No way, not after what she's put me through.
What do you reckon, Brum? Shave the bitch's hair off?
Hack off one of her ears and send it to Merle for compensation.
Look, we're only asking for more trouble. I mean, they've cut back on our spud since last time we got her. She's probably had enough anyway.
Hey, watch what you're doing with that soap powder.
It's all right, I'm measuring it.
Well, with a sieve.
Gonna float out of here on bubbles, are you, Brumby?
Listen, will ya? The screws are going to be giving it to her for what she did to Jackson. We've got to stand by her, don't we?
Oh, get off! I reckon we should give her a dose of her own medicine. Give her a gumful of smack and see how she likes that.
That's the trouble. She probably would.
I reckon Reet might like to have a say in all this if she ever gets back.
Okay, she's only been gone an hour or so.
Yeah, Reno said they'd be talking through the reforms together.
She's probably organising a day at Portsea for us right now.
Why not?
Something's wrong. I can feel it. Cover for us till we get back.
Hope she didn't try escaping without us.
Doing in here with the bloody door shut? You're down for laundry.
Shower.
You got both oars in the water or what? Ferguson will make a lampshade out of you.
Ferguson doesn't count.
Water must have been cold.
Yeah.
Well, the girls were worried about you. What's wrong with your foot?
Oh, nothing. Some tests they had done.
Well, couldn't have been too good. You didn't say much about it. All that poking and pushing you around like a lump of meat. Jeez, it must have been...
Please. Leave me alone, will you, for a minute?
Jeez, it might help to talk about it.
Talk about it? Lying on me back for 3 hours, staring at the ceiling while they pump blue crap into my feet. Pinned to a table while some kid doctor stuffs around in here trying to find a vein so he can shoot me up with some other crap. 120 feet per second, Lurch. That's how fast they shoot it in. So some other bloody machine could take pictures of me about what's going on inside. 120 feet per second. I wish me Harley would go that fast. And that's only while I was conscious. Why would I want to talk about that? Jeez, Reet, the screws will walk out of here.
You think I care about what the screws think? That's what I think about the bastard screws.
Reet?
Reet!
Just have to get some air, okay?
You be all right by yourself? Just make sure you're back inside for dinner.
Jenkins, come back here.
Mrs. Morris, have you seen Reet? She was headed this way.
Oh, you're on a charge, Jenkins. You know better than that. She slipped through, Mrs. Morris. I'll take her back.
It's all right. It's all right. I'll take care of it. Well, what's going on? Thought she was going to thump someone and then Mrs. Radcliffe let her waltz through the gate.
Alice, just settle down, will you? Rita has permission to go outside. Although it's probably a good idea if someone was with her.
I'll go.
Alice. Just let Reet do the talking if she wants to. Don't push her.
Gotcha. Reet! Jeez, fingers are going to be a mess if you don't let go of that fence.
I just need a bit of space, Lurch, all right?
Sorry. Didn't mean to go sticking me foot in me mouth about all that hospital stuff.
Just forget about it, will you?
Sorry. Oh, I should have known when you weren't talking about it.
You just shut up and get out of here!
Sorry.
And stop apologising all the time.
Well, look, if you told me what I was doing wrong, I could...
You haven't done anything wrong!
Oh, jeez, well, what am I supposed to do? I'm not used to you cracking the sulks like this.
You two, get away from that fence.
Come on, he's not joking.
Get away from the fence!
Oh, come on, he'll take a crack at us.
Don't let him...
You off your head?
Let him do it. I'm going to die anyway. Let him do it.
You what?
It's all through me, Lurch. And no bastard can stop it.
I'm sorry. I shouldn't bring you in on this.
It doesn't make me feel like much of a mate. You're not telling me.
Oh, I didn't mean it like that.
You could quit apologising too.
I guess I just couldn't figure it out. When it hit me, I didn't know what to think.
You don't get news like that every day.
Once in a lifetime.
Well, you're not facing it on your lonesome. The girls can help us do something about
it.
Oh, but...
This is between you and me.
No worries. I suppose everyone's got an uncle or a cousin or something. They'd all be telling you about everything.
Yeah. God, Ferguson and Adams will have a field day.
Well, at least Reno will stick up for you. They won't pull nothing.
Yeah, she's okay. She reckons she can get me out of here.
Oh,
compassionate pardon or something.
Oh, jeez, Ripper. At least something good's come out of this.
I'm not going.
Oh, but you can't hang around in here. You should be out there having a ball.
Who with? Slasher and Bongo are both gone. The rest of the boys aren't much chop, and I reckon I'm the last thing that Ida needs at the moment.
But she loves you, Richard.
I said no. I don't want to make the rest of her life miserable too. I just want to see her sitting pretty before it. Oh, I don't know. I reckon Ida can have a pretty good account of herself. Now, what about that time Ferguson couldn't find her? She had every alarm in the place going off. Ida just invited herself to afternoon tea with the governor.
Yeah. Hi, Ruth. Hi, Oz.
Hi, Harry.
Thought these might brighten up the place a bit.
Oh, thanks. They're beauties.
Yeah, my old gran always said, give me me flowers now. I can't see them when they're on me grave.
Oh, Harry, look, we're right in the middle of something. I'll catch you later, right?
Yeah, sorry. Yeah, later, okay.
God, everyone's apologising for something today.
I'm sorry that had to happen, Mr. Proctor, but unless we can discuss Merle Jones' case in person, all I can do is assure you that he is acting on our behalf.
Sounds like our Mr. Lucas has been firing off a few rounds.
That one certainly missed its mark. The deputy superintendent. Tom bailed him up in the driveway outside his house.
He's got initiative, all right.
Gall, I'd call it. He pulled the keys out of Proctor's ignition to stop him driving away.
Tom might be right.
The bulldozer approach.
Well, you've certainly had enough doors slammed in your face trying to get Merle back.
Well, I thought I knew enough about red tape by now to make a few shortcuts.
Well, let's see what he can do. At least that sort of reaction is better than no reaction at all.
It's Merle I'm worried about. He's convinced her he can bring her back. If she's let down again, Tom might be doing more harm than good.
Well, I better get back and see if I can get my pig-headed son to see me.
Yes, Janice. Meg. Maxwell's back.
Tell him everything you know and you're
deciding. I'm right out there.
Tell me the whole truth about this stinking
That's enough, business. Sonny. What the hell do you think you're doing?
Getting my job back. She traded that off to get out of here.
Jackson, isn't it? I think I've heard just about enough of you. Now, get out of here.
Yeah, well, you're going to hear a hell of a lot more. She doesn't clear this
That's
mess
it,
up.
Mate. Clear off or you're booked.
Come on. You're low, Maxwell. But don't worry. Merle's going to testify as soon as she gets over what you did to her.
Pretty good touch of them seedlings.
Oh, g'day. Not much to it, really. It's a bit late for those little nippers, but they should take.
Mind if I give you a hand?
Oh, I thought you'd never ask. Shouldn't you be inside? A bit early to be out here, isn't it?
I've got special permission. What are these? Fuchsias or something?
Nah, poison ivy. I'll let it grow and then send a huge bouquet to Ferguson. Look, I didn't mean to bust in like I did before. Look, I never was known for me good timing.
Don't worry about it. Reed just needs some room to move.
She got a problem?
That's one thing these buggers haven't got. Got to spend all their growing time just stuck in the one place until they give us some more.
Well, they're probably not too worried about it. They wouldn't know they're locked away with a life sentence.
Better off than us then, aren't they? Better off not knowing where they are or what's going to happen to them. Bet they don't even know how long they've got.
I don't know, Alice. I reckon they know they've got to go sooner or later, and they know they've got their mates standing
beside them. Not bloody much the mates can do, is there? Just watching and waiting. Can't even lift a finger.
I reckon they're a bit like people. What is it, Alice?
Harry. Why, Harry? Why?
It's all right, love. It's all right.
Your name is Catherine Lorraine Maxwell, is that correct? Is that correct?
Yes, just get on with it.
You've been charged with escaping lawful custody, resisting arrest and murder.
It was self-defense. Why won't anyone believe
that? Quiet, Maxwell. Are the charges correct?
Yes. If that liar Denson thinks he'll get away with this, he's
going to... That'll be up to the courts to decide. I thought you'd have had more sense than to go near Merle Jones.
Why didn't you do something about her? If you saw the state she was in, it was
your responsibility. She has you to thank for that, as well as a charge for attempted escape.
Come along, Maxwell. You know where the Shahs are.
I want her out of there. You know she had nothing to do with it.
Of course she didn't. But my hands are tied. The department decides
Look,
what happens in a case like that.
Get her out of there and I'll give you the straight facts on the escape. You want names, you'll have them on a plate.
I think that'd be in your best interests anyway, Maxwell.
Maybe. But unless you do something about Merle, I think Mr. Jackson's going to miss out on his last chance to clear himself.
Are you saying you know something about the heroine?
I want your word.
You've got it. But if this is some sort of deception...
I'll tell! Look, whatever you want, just get her out of there. I couldn't stand seeing her like...
So what's happening? What's going on?
It's all over. They dropped all the charges.
Oh, great.
Well, there'll be a few more if you don't let go of the prisoner. Your reinstatement's effective immediately.
Just when I was getting my drug empire off the ground.
They're going to reopen my case.
You'll have to win this time. I'll testify. Lisa will testify.
No, she's in enough trouble. I feel like I've left a string of dead bodies behind me as it is.
Yeah, all the way back to Christine Dunn.
Well, lucky you didn't join them. Now, I'll take you back to the rec room. I suppose you want to tell the news.
Take your break. The Scourge of Wentworth is back. I'll take it out.
I think the Scourge would be better off putting on his uniform. Anyway, I want to set the women straight about any retribution against Maxwell.
I almost felt sorry for her. She's really screwed up.
Yes. The way she was talking about Merle.
Well, I wouldn't expect any sympathy from the women. It's not just Merle. She's got more enemies than Fergus.
Well, just make sure you stay out of it. I've had enough trouble for a while.
Yes, sir.
Well, the governor wants to see you before you put your uniform on.
Oh, tell me the good news herself, eh?
I think she'll be giving you advice on how to keep out of trouble.
Mad keeping it to yourself. They're your mates.
That's why I'm doing it. They won't let me do nothing for them if they know I'm on the way out.
They'll find out sometimes.
We're not making too much noise for you, are we? I mean, it must be difficult working out how you're going to run the country.
Yeah, what about a superannuation scheme for Queens?
I'll knock it off, you lot. We're just having a talk.
You're getting good at that. What gives, Connors?
Yeah, you got something contagious. I'm getting out of here.
What, again? No, I've just got a wog. Could have a few jabs. I'm going to have the easy life up in the infirmary for a couple of days, aren't I, Lurch?
Yeah. She even talked Mrs. Reynolds into giving her light duties when she gets back.
Yeah? Tell us the symptoms and I'll join the queue.
Forget it. The doctors take one look at you, they'll put you in the same playpen as Merle.
Uh-huh. Shut your mouth, McPherson. Thought you two were supposed to be in the palace.
Let's look at the side of the ugly bitch.
Take it easy, Reed.
Oh, is everything all right in here?
Oh, no worries, Mrs. Morris.
All right, well, I'm sure you've all heard about Maxwell's recapture, so I'll say this only once. Mrs. Reynolds and I are well aware of your feelings towards Maxwell, so we'll tolerate no recriminations.
Don't worry. We'll let her stew in her own juice.
Hey, what's the matter with her? She got her lips super glued or something.
I'm in the clear. Maxwell cracked and told them everything. We beat him, Brock.
You and Leif can come for tea.
Hey, we're going to get Maxwell tonight, all right?
Shave the bitch's hair off. What do you reckon?
Might be too much for her at the moment. Never seen her look so bad. What do you think, Reet?
Oh, well, I reckon you're the one who copped it. It's up to you.
Hey, she made you look pretty stupid. Aren't you going to nail her for that?
Look, I don't give a stuff. What happens to her?
Great. We got a top dog who's letting everyone get away with murder. You said no escapes or else, right, Brum?
Oh, I don't know. Reet might be right.
Okay, if you're going to carry on like this, we'll do something. But I can tell you I'm getting awfully sick of holding your hands all the time.
Oh, don't worry. The pleasure's going to be all mine. And anyone else who wants to be in it with me? Come on, Brum. Let's go make some plans.
Look, Alison, I don't care if he does play tennis with an advertising tycoon. Well, it's television for a start. What about the stage? What does this joker know about Oscar Wilde and Thornton Wilder and... Yes, I know I can't get your partner toothpaste. Don't I mean anything to you? I'm sorry, Alison, I didn't realise I was so inadequate. Look, when you got all this out of your system, I just want you to know that, Alison...
That's showbiz, Rod.
What the hell are you doing sneaking around here?
Oh, I thought you might need a friendly shoulder. Bit too hot for you, was she?
At least I don't have to drug mine to get what I want.
I think you're wearing my jacket.
This? Yeah. Had an accident in the laundry. Didn't think you'd be needing yours for a while.
Well, I'm back on duty right now to get it off.
Oh, sure, but the suspension, the charges...
I'm cleared. Get it off.
I just want you to know that I didn't really believe for a second when I found the drugs that had anything to do with it, no.
I'm as guilty as hell, but you know how it is.
I do.
Sure, you were always telling me Meg was getting me out of the tight spots and you were right. So this time I decided I'd pull a few strings and snap.
Right.
So I thought, why shouldn't you and I do a little business together?
You did?
Yeah. Drugs.
Drugs?
Right. Now we get hold of all the women, fill them up full of drugs, get hold of a video camera, and we make a toothpaste commercial.
You're a bastard, Jackson.
Oi! Your jacket.
If you have any problems, I suggest you report them to the governor.
I can look after myself.
Now, no talking to Maxwell. Plenty of others wishing to use this flat if you don't observe the rules.
Oh, no worries, Mrs. M. We're not going to waste any words on her.
Well, just don't do anything silly.
I reckon we should start giving it to Maxwell right now. Look at her.
Oh, let's leave it. She's had it tough enough.
Oh, no, she hasn't. You must have been missing us, Cass.
Brumby's right.
Bet you couldn't wait to get back to us.
Had a message from Merle.
She said, thanks for nothing.
Yeah, you done some pretty low things in your time, Maxwell, but this is the pits.
Girls around here don't like scumbags turning on their mates.
That's a laugh. Why don't you ask Tucker about mates? Well, I don't know what she's talking about.
Why don't you tell Spike how you went along with setting up her and Jackson? You kept your mouth shut so you could get out of here with me and Merle.
You lying bitch! And I was hanging off getting you.
Ask her.
You heard then. What's she trying to pull? Brum?
You reckon Brooke Shields wears a wig?
You're probably better off working on your eyebrows.
Nah, don't reckon Harry'd go for that. Don't know what he'd go for. Some guys like some things,
but... Save us the details, will you, Lute?
Yeah. Just keeps looking in me eyes like he can't see nothing else. Says they're as soft as a yearling's.
Soft as your head, more like.
I'm just trying to make conversation. It's not easy for me either, you know.
Yes, I know. I'm sorry. Just been thinking about that chemo.
Oh, it sounds bloody awful. But if it gives you a couple extra months...
Live fast, die young, leave a good-looking corpse, Ulrich.
Look, you've got to go through with it. What if it works just better than they say?
Right?
Meant to give you this. Dropped it on the floor.
You know what this makes me think?
Shouldn't you two be at dinner?
I thought I told you not to come barging in here.
Oh, Miss Ferguson, if you've got a problem, perhaps we could go outside and sort it out.
It's a social call, Jenkins. I want to talk to Connors alone.
I like it right where I am.
The governor told me about your problem.
I bet the screws are running a book on how long I'll last.
She knows?
Or who I'll take with me when I go.
Attitude isn't going to help you at all.
Dead people don't spend much time thinking about attitudes.
Don't play tough with me, Connors. I can see right through you.
Then you can tell what I want you to do right now.
I admire your guts. But don't waste them causing trouble. You're going to need all the courage you can get.
What was that all about?
Maybe the freak's got a heart of gold after all.
Yeah. Or she's scared stupid. She's going to hit the fan.
Sounds like a pretty healthy bet each way to me.
I just heard the good news, Marsh.
Yeah.
Don't worry. I'm sure we'll find something else to keep you off the streets.
I was wondering where you got to. Thought maybe we could have a bit of a talk. Well, what Maxwell said, that wasn't the way it happened. Believe me, I didn't know she was lining you up. I cottoned onto the escape. Well, she wouldn't say nothing about the deal. I got the lumps, remember?
You knew. You kept your mouth shut just so you could get out.
It was my chance. Well, everyone thinks I'm a nong and I just want to do it proper once. She had it all set up.
And for that, you see me back on smack?
Oh, Spike, we're going
I was trying to prove my innocence, you selfish bitch. Look, I'll chuck the flat and we can sort it out tonight.
There's nothing to sort out. I'm getting another cell as soon as I can fix it.
Spike, we're Blackmore.
You're Blackmore, Brumby. Never think that place ever was. Maybe you should have gone down with it.
I think it's the best report on the system I've ever read. It's education with defined goals. It treats rehabilitation as something worthwhile, not just a nightmare that won't go away. But I think it's the best report on the system that nobody else will read.
You're talking about Dwyer?
I think it'll make people wonder why he didn't come up with the ideas
himself.
He's
had our views off the record for long enough. It's time we had someone else's opinion.
Opinion is hardly the word I'd use for anything Mr. Dwyer has to say, and I don't want to see all your hard work end up as a very literate doorstop.
It's not the only copy, Meg. And I've met enough people during the last 4 years to make sure it does get read.
Well, I'll deliver them all myself in a swimsuit if you think it'll help.
This time I'm going over Dwyer's head. You can sink or swim.
Sorry, not interrupting anything, am I? Bloody traffic. I would have been here 20 minutes ago. Hi, mate.
Hi, Tom.
I've been through more doctors than the Nuremberg trials. They're not as stupid as most people think. Merle's lovely, isn't she?
Well, she's not the monster people make her out.
Here it is. All we need is your signature.
What for?
Merle's release. We can get her back tonight.
Stupid bitch.
You're gonna catch your death if you sit around here.
So what?
I was wondering where you got to.
Yeah? You'd be the only one. Look, I didn't know Maxwell was gonna get Spike.
Yeah, I believe you. You both know what a slimy bitch he is, don't
we? Yeah, well, I got the lumps to prove it.
It's not all you got. You got style. Spider was always talking about you.
Yeah?
Sure. She was always asking me if I thought you'd be good to have on side. But I never could stomach that Spike much. Look, we're missing out on a top time. We could be having a real rage in the flat.
Yeah, you might be right.
Of course I am. Stick with me, kid. You saw how I handled those jerks in Wreck? Here, give us your hand. Feeling up to a bit of fun?
Yeah, well, I got a few tapes and stuff.
I reckon we both owe Maxwell a little visit.
Don't know why you bother hanging around this time of night. Give them a belly full of food and all I want to do is sleep.
Haven't you heard about Connors?
Oh, yeah, that.
I'm not with you.
Oh, come on, we're men of the world. You'd expect a slag like that to come down with something, wouldn't you?
Are you all right?
What do you mean?
I'd like to have a word if I could.
Then we lose the boy, Scout.
Watch your mouth, Connors.
Rod, do you know anything about infectious diseases?
I have to go and lock the reward cell. Call if you need me.
It's good to see someone's got a sense of humour.
That kind of breaks me up.
You're not the only one.
So where are the card and flowers, Lucas? I gather you've heard.
Yeah. Must be pretty tough.
What do you know about it?
I saw a few guys go down in the army. They were scared, but they knew there was no point in making a song and dance about it.
Maybe I'm the one who doesn't know anything.
We can fix that.
How?
Books. I'll get you everything you need to know on the subject. You can read, can't you?
Of course I can read.
Well, at least that way you'll know exactly what's going on, if you want to face up to it.
Are you giving me a hard time or what?
No offense. I wouldn't blame you if you wanted to bury your head in the sand.
Well, when Harley used to chuck a wobbly, I'd break out the manual, find out what was going wrong.
Harley, eh? I got this old Norton. I pulled the gearbox down a couple of months ago, still haven't been able to get it back together.
Oh, it's a piece of cake. I'll tell you what, you give me the books and talk me through the medical crap, and I'll give you a few pointers how to get your gearbox back together.
You got a deal. You know that double core flange on the 850?
Yeah, slots in over the second gear countershaft. Maxwell.
Hey, Maxwell, wake up. Got a note for you. It's from your loopy mate.
Girl, she's back?
The screws will be down in a minute. Do you want it or not?
I don't see why you'd be doing me any favours.
Well, I'm just in it for the lollies. Merle's a big spender.
Thanks.
One peep and they go through your throat.
Why don't you just do it and get it over with?
Too easy, you lagging bitch. The women are backing me on this. When they get a load of you in the morning, they're going to be backing me on a lot of other stuff I've got planned.
What do you two think?
We're going to screw on side and we're laughing.
Well, you've got a few mistakes and we've been learning from them.
We look after our mates, Maxwell. So we're going to give you a free barber job just to show you how generous we are. Hold it tighter.
What's going on down there? Back against the wall.
She looks so lonely, Mr. Adams.
Yeah, just giving her a cuddle. Tell her everything will be just ducky in the morning.
You all right, Maxwell? You're both on report. I'll have you out of here first thing in the morning. Now get inside.
See you later, Carl.
Do someone a favour and that's a face of death.
I don't know what you mean. And I thought you were something special. You kill your child, turn your back on your mates, and now murder someone.
I wouldn't have expected you to believe me. But the truth is going to come out about all this.
The truth came out a long time ago, Maxwell. I was just too stupid to see it. You scum. You deserve everything you get.
exception. Yeah, what is it, Bob? Well, tell him to come back in the morning.
I'm saying that.
Oh, all right, I'll handle it.
I wouldn't be any fun again, because I know all about it, wouldn't I? Hope Mr. Jackson. Oh, hi, Miss Ferguson. Do you like me new jammers? These are me two new friends.
What's she
this
doing here?
Doug Hawkins.
I don't care who you are. You'll not bring her in here outside official prison hours.
I'm sorry. We haven't got the authority to take her back again. We've got to get this form signed.
Well, you'd better get on the phone and find somebody who has. I will not have this prison interrupted with an induction at this hour of the night.
But I live here, Miss Ferguson. Look, I've just put the address and all the books. I'll show you.
Jones.
Merle. How you doing?
Oh, hi, Mr. Lucas. Please, can I stay here, please?
Of course you can. Good day, fellas.
Mr. Lucas?
Oh, hi, Joan. Sorry, I didn't see you there.
Thanks. Come on, Phil. We're due for a break.
Got a bit of stuff here, Merle. Doing some reading, are you?
Yeah. This one's Wind in the Willows. It's got this toad in it that talks too much and is always driving into things.
Yeah, I want to hear all about it, but first I think we better get you settled for the night. Is there a single dorm for Merle, Miss Ferguson?
Oh, I thought since you were organising everything tonight, you might like to arrange that yourself.
No worries. H4 is empty. I'll take her down there. Come on. Both pyjamas are great, Merle. Where'd you get them?
Oh, When I went to that place, they gave them to me.
Oi, Maxwell. You asleep yet? Nah, she likes the dark. No one can see her coming. We're gonna see a lot of you, Maxwell. You're gonna end up like Yul Brynner when I get me scissors back. How's it feel, Maxwell? Still using your brains? You always were smarter than us.
Brains?
No, nobody with any brains would leave herself open like that. Every screw and crim in the place is just waiting for a piece of her. Sweet dreams, princess.
It's all right, Ree. You've been dreaming. Oh, God. It's bloody sweat. It's coming every night. I'll get something to cool you down.
I wasn't shooting my mouth off, was I?
Nah, not much. Hey, you want a drink while I'm up?
Come on, get it out. What was I saying?
Oh, just a bit about Bongo and the bikes. I didn't catch much of it.
Yes, I can remember this crazy dream about Dan the man.
Yeah, there's a bit about that too.
I can do that. I'm not a bloody cripple,
you
know.
I know you can, but let me do it, all right?
I wasn't singing no hymns either, was I?
No, it's a bit about your mum, that's all. Oh, forget it. Hey, you must have dropped this again when you were throwing yourself about.
Just keep it, will you?
It's yours. It's a Harley.
Yes, I know that, Lurch. What's the point of hanging on to it?
You always said it was important. You can't go turning your back on it now just because it doesn't fit the bill anymore.
Get it into your head, Lurch. I don't fit the bill anymore. When was the last time I chewed up any bitumen? Did you see any grease under these? I haven't had the stink of petrol up my nose so long I wouldn't know what it smelt like.
But your mates, they'd call you a wimp if they could see you. What about the runs and the rages and all
my
the things?
My mates are in here. And nobody's going to call them wimps.
But the bikes, right?
If I'm going out like the doc says, I'd have to be strapped onto one. And no one, no one disgraces a Harley like that. It's the bike, Lurch. Not the bitch who rides it.
Merle?
Oh, it was an accident, honest, Mr. Jackson.
What are you doing down here by yourself?
I heard the bell and I come down like I always do, but there wasn't no one here. I thought I was in the wrong prison.
You haven't had your shower yet, have you?
Oh, them bells all sound the same to me, but I had one last night.
All right, well, make sure you have a quick wash after breakfast, okay? Down. I think you can welcome her back without wrecking the place.
Hey, Mr. Jackson, we heard your good news.
Thank you. What I need right now, though, is someone to help me carry this up to the punishment cell.
Not unless I can slip something in it.
Wouldn't mind feeding it to her myself.
Come on, Anson. You don't look as though you need to eat right away.
Oh, come on, Reed. I'm starving. I've got lots to tell you. Oh, I missed you, Merle. Oh, thanks, mate.
She's a real criminal, right? Killed someone, didn't you, Maxwell? Yeah, we saw what was left of him on the news last night.
Yeah, tough looking bloke.
Oh, she probably got him in the back.
Business as usual, I'm...
Up against the wall.
I thought you would have paid me a personal visit last night.
Shut up.
You're lucky I take my job seriously.
I'm sure there'll be plenty of others who don't.
Hey, I reckon that's worth a clip with a baton any day.
Mr. Adams told you to have your things packed first thing this morning. Now, you know the rules.
Oh, come on. We were just helping settle her in. Thought you'd appreciate us giving her a bit of friendship.
Yeah, you can bet nobody else will.
Get down to breakfast. You can pack up when you're finished. There's another two ready for the reward flat this morning.
Well, that's the end of that. And I was looking forward to a decent brekkie in front of the telly.
Yeah, it wouldn't have happened if the slag wasn't here.
Hope you choke on yours, Maxwell. You just can't do nothing right, can you?
Didn't they give you a decent feed at that place?
Oh, it wasn't too bad, but I would have given anything for some of that chilli sauce.
Yeah. Oh, gee, someone's been mucking around with these things.
Oh, a bit hard up for a laugh there too, was it?
Oh, it was real funny sometimes. There was this one fella there that kept sounding like a rooster every time one of the nurses walked past.
A what?
Well, it's good to see you're all in such high spirits.
Oh, yeah, Spike was telling me that you're not in trouble with the drugs anymore, and she's not mad at me or nothing, are you, Spike?
That's great. Got some good news for you two as well.
Yeah?
As soon as you finish your breakfast, you can pack a few things together and get down to the reward flat.
Oh, geez, Mr. Jackson, thanks. Great, eh? This time I won't be stuck with that slob Dimmick. We'll have a ball.
A pretty lucky coincidence. People might be queuing up for that disease of yours.
Wouldn't bet on it.
What disease? You sick?
Hey, Merle, how about you and Spike coming down with us after for a few chuckles? You can be our guests.
Yeah?
Don't let them get to you.
I'm not. I just wanted a decent brekkie. Oh, look at this slop.
No, I saw your last attempt. Jackson might have done me a favour.
Don't you start.
Take it easy. We'll stick together. We'll have this place on its knees.
Got to learn they don't go leaving their mates high and dry.
Look, I'm getting another cell and no one's talking to me, so let's just leave it at that.
Hey, Vicar, why don't you use this one? The one over there's blocked.
So what do you reckon, Merle? You all set for a grand tour of the flat?
Yeah, can we go now?
Hey, we can go soon.
Hey, it's really good down there, even better than Disneyland. I was going to go to Disneyland once.
Yeah, who with?
I don't remember.
Wasn't Kath talking about it, was it?
I don't remember nobody named Kath.
Well, sure you do. You used to share a cell with her.
She used to read to you all the time.
I don't remember nobody named Kath. I said so, didn't I?
Merle. Are you all right? I'm going to be out of here tomorrow. Maybe
my plan's a rotten egg.
Beats me why that took so long.
Are you all right, Merle?
Hey, it's a great place, isn't it?
Yeah. I sat on one as pretty as this one's, but the man in the shop made me get off.
Hey, listen to this. Oh.
We can get our own disco going and everything.
It's loud, isn't it? We can hear it through your feet.
Come on, let's go and have a look in the fridge for half an hour since breakfast. She must be starving.
No, she's coming to have a dance with me.
No, she's coming with me. Hey, we can go out any time we like.
Can we go out now? Because then we can come back and play some more music and then we can watch the telly and then we can make scones and...
Merle's just making herself feel right at home, Mrs. Reynolds.
Good.
That's the whole idea. I wanted to have a word with you.
Yeah, sure. Lurch was just going outside for a minute.
Is it okay if she takes Merle with her?
Yes.
That's all right.
Alice, come on, let's play Heidi. Come on.
All right, Merle. I know we were pushing you too hard yesterday, but Dr. Lund's just been on the phone. He says if you agree to go through with the chemotherapy, you'll have to start straight away.
Oh, I don't know, Mrs. Reynolds. Lurch reckons I'm mad, but if my body's given up, then
you'll have to take every chance you can get, Rita. I've had cancer. Not as serious as yours, of course, but for a time I couldn't face it, couldn't bear anyone near me or even talking about it. I had friends who gave me the guts to fight it every inch of the way. Well, if you reckon it's worth a try, I'll give it a bash. When do we start? It won't take long to organise. Then it's up to the doctor.
Well, I better make the most of this then while I'm feeling up to it, eh?
Good luck.
Request, Max.
give me roses. I wish he could again. But that was on the outside, and things were different then. On the inside, the sun still shines. The sun and rain are prisoners too. When morning comes around, last night I dreamed we were together, sharing all the love we'd known. Till I had to face the nightmare, awaken up alone. Right.